Hello guys, welcome back. This is Surendra and we are going to continue our digital lecture series. So in this series, till now we have done in sequential circuit, we have done latch, SR latch using NAND and NOR gate, and then SR flip-flop. Now we are going to continue with JK flip-flop. So in last lecture, we have seen that in SR flip-flop, there is one disadvantage that when both S and R are 1, then we cannot use that condition because that is invalid condition. To remove that condition, we will use JK flip-flop. So how we will remove that condition, we will see. So we have seen that this is the SR flip-flop. Here this is the SR latch, and then we include two NAND gate, so it become SR flip-flop. Now I will implement the JK flip-flop using SR flip-flop I have to add some 2-3 more connections, then it will become JK flip-flop. So we have seen that this is the truth table for SR latch using NAND gate, because we are implementing everything using NAND gate. Now you can implement by NOR gate also. So what now we have to see that how the JK flip-flop going to work. So I have taken one terminal from here and going to connect here. One terminal from here, and I have connected here. So this becomes JK flip-flop. Here the S is equal to J and R is equal to K. So this is nothing but JK flip-flop. Or if you want to represent into the block, so you can take one. This is clock, this is suppose S and this is R. So this is SR flip-flop. Now I am going to continue this terminal at S and this terminal at J. So this becomes JK flip-flop, where S is equal to J and R is equal to K. This is nothing but JK flip-flop. So how it will work, we will see that thing. So the first condition, when as a clock is equal to 0, clock is equal to 0, so here will be 0, 0 into something will be 0, 0 complement of 0, complement of 0 will be 1 1. So here the input will be 1 and 1, 1 and 1. So for in SR latch, for input 1 and 1, what is the output? The output is QN here. So here we will make the J K QN plus 1, and this is clock. When clock is 0, doesn't matter what is J and K, that will be always QN. So first condition, we have done this condition. When clock is on, then here we have four conditions. When like these all four conditions. So when J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 0. So when this is 0, doesn't matter any other thing, that's 0 into something will be 1 and 0 into something will be 1. So 1 1 will give same condition. That means when clock is 1 and both are 0, that will also give QN only. Now third condition, when clock is 1 and J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 1. So see, when J is equal to 0, 0 into something will give 0 and 0 complement will give 1. Here, this is also 1, this is also 1, and this is q. So here will be 1 into 1 into q bar. Here will be q bar only. Q bar. So see now, when this condition arrives, so what is the output? At s, that is 1, and at r, that is q bar. These two conditions we got. Now consider, if q is equal to 0, q is equal to 0, then this will be s is equal to 1 and r is equal to 1, because 0 complement 1. So s is equal to 1 and r is equal to 1 will give qn. Qn means qn is this one. So this will be 0 only. In this condition, the output qn plus 1 will be 0 only. If q is equal to 1, if q is equal to 1, then s will be equal to 1 and r will be equal to 0. So see here, s is equal to 1, r is equal to 0. Output is 0. So here also qn plus 1 will be 0 only. So in both conditions, when clock is equal to 1 and j is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1, the output will be 0 only. So see, now for clock is equal to 1 and j is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1, the output is 0 always. Now for third condition, when the j is equal to 1 and k is equal to 0, j is equal to 1 and k is equal to 0. Here what will be? J is equal to 1 means 1 into this one, q bar. So this will give q bar, k bar, double bar will cancel. That means this will be q only. And here k is equal to 0, so this will be 1 only, 1. So here now we have s is equal to q and r is equal to 1. Now if q is equal to 0, then what will be the output? 0 and 1. For 0 and 1, 0 and 1, output will be 1. So qn plus 1, if q is equal to 0, qn plus 1 will be 1. If q is equal to 1, then 1 and 1 will give qn, means previous state. So previous stage is 1 only. So qn plus 1 is equal to 1. So in this condition when clock is 1 and j is 1, this is 0, this always give 1. Now the final condition for which we have implemented this JK flip-flop. What that condition is? When j is equal to 1 and k also is equal to 1, what will be the output? So see, the output is like here this is coming q. So 1 into 1 into q, here 1 into 1 into q bar. So this will give q bar, ka whole bar will give q, and this will give q bar. So here for sr latch, the input will be s is equal to will be q and r is equal to will be q bar. What it? So now we have to consider the conditions. What will be? If q is equal to 0, q is equal to 0, so 0 and 1. 0 and 1 gives this one. 0 and 1 gives 1. So q1 plus 1 will be 1. If q is equal to 1, that means 1 and 0. 1 and 0 will give 0. So qn plus 1 will be 0. So this is the condition. Now what, look at here, what happened? It is just complementing 0 to 1. If the previous stage is 0, then this become 1 if j is equal to 1 and k is equal to 1. If this is 1, then this become 0. So it is toggling. We have given one term called toggle. So when both are 1 and 1, so it will October. So now this is the JK flip-flop. Now we have to see the characteristic table of JK flip-flop and the excitation table of JK flip-flop. So first remember this truth table. This is the truth table for JK flip-flop. Now with the help of this one, we will implement the characteristic table of JK flip-flop and the excitation table of JK flip-flop. Here each condition in JK flip-flop is similar as SR flip-flop except this condition. This condition is changed here in SR flip-flop. This is unused, but in JK flip-flop it will toggle the output. That means it will complement the output. So guys, what we have seen that in SR flip-flop and JK flip-flop only one difference is there in last condition, that is when S is equal to 1 and R is equal to 1. In SR flip-flop, that stage is not useful. But in JK flip-flop, we have designed such that in that condition the output is toggled. So now we have to make the characteristic table as we have done in the SR flip-flop. We will do same in JK flip-flop and calculate one equation. So guys, I have written these all conditions. So when J and K are 0, so we know that the output will be Qn only, means previous stage. So here the output will be previous stage. So this will be 0 and this will be 1. When the J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 1, the output always is equal to 0. So in this condition, the output will be 0 and 0. When J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 0, so output will be always 1. So this in both condition, output will be 1 and 1. And when J is equal to 1 and K is equal to 1, the output is toggle. So here the previous stage is 0, that means this will be 1. And here the previous stage is 1, this will be 0. So this is nothing but whatever we have done in SR flip-flop, same thing I have done in JK flip-flop. Now what we have to do, we have to put into the K-map and we have to calculate the characteristic equation. So here we are getting the value at when J and K are 0 and Q and R 1. So this, and I have put it all other value also. You can guess whatever we have done in K map and SR flip flop, same thing I have done here. So I am not going to waste the time. So here now we have to make the pair. So here no quad, so just we will make pair only. So one pair this one and this one is other pair. Now calculate the equation. So Qn plus 1 is equal to, this one is both are changing, so this will be K bar into Qn, K bar into Qn plus this one is this is J into this thing is K is changing, so J into Qn bar, J into Qn bar. So this is the characteristic equation for JK flip-flop. This is the characteristic equation, and this is very important if you have to implement any other circuitry using JK flip-flop. So please keep in mind this thing and SR flip-flop, this characteristic table. So you have to keep in mind. And after that, we are going to implement the excitation table. So in excitation table, we have to see the input Qn and Qn plus 1. And then what will be the value of J and K. So we will see. So guys, this is the all conditions. So we have to see when like qn is 0 and qn plus 1 is 0, what will be the j and k? So here we have seen that, we already have seen here in intro table, that when j means qn will be, when qn is equal to qn plus 1, that means first condition is this one. So this is the first condition, when q means j will be equal to k, 0 0 0 0. And second thing, when like qn plus 1 is 0, qn plus 1 is 0 when j is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1, this will be 0. When j is equal to 0, k is equal to 1, this will be 0 in both conditions. So when j is equal to, this is suppose j, this is k. When j and k is equal to 0, this condition can be arrived. And when j is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1, this condition will be arrived. So that means k can be 0 and 1 both, and j can be 0 only. So 0 and don't care. That means here will be 0 and don't care. What about this one? This one, when, here also two condition, when it is toggle, and second thing, when it is the value of qn plus 1 is 1. So the value of qn plus 1 is 1 at when j is equal to 1 and k is equal to 0. And when it is toggle, when j is equal to 1 and k is equal to 1. So this will be, this is 1 1 1 1 and this is 0 1. So this is don't care, this is 1. So this is 1 and this is don't care. And then for this one, just opposite. Because when qn plus 1 is 0, we already have seen qn plus 1 is 0 when j is equal to 0 and k is equal to 1. And when it is toggle, like it is also condition for toggling. So when the both are 1, so j is changing, so this is don't care, this is 1. So this is don't care, this is 1. When it is 1 and 1, when it is 1 and 1. So first condition is when both are equal, both are equal, like qn is equal to qn plus 1. That condition is when j is equal to 0 and k is equal to 0. And second condition, when qn plus 1 is 1, when we have j is equal to 1 and k is equal to 0. So this is don't care, j is don't care, and this is 0. So see, here we have one point, that these two conditions are complement. So here the value also, like in this, j is 0 and k is cross, means don't care. Here j is cross and k is 0, and same as here also. So you can remember by these tricks. So that's it for today, and next we will cover the D flip-flop. So thank you very much.